This thing reads 30, it indicates that it's a sort of a decent level of hygiene. Basically, it's clean. Anything over 30, then it gets into the danger zone. This is where the smell is really bad in here. There's crap everywhere. It's just so unhygienic. Undo that. I just want to doesn't feel clean.
To get a good reading, rub the swab underneath the mat. The smell under here is appalling. In these crevices, there's dirt. That's gross. That's gross.
That is disgusting. Snap it, let the liquid go down. Give that a shake. In.
Holy crap.
No. I'm unconvinced that this place is clean. Everything smells. It's very difficult for you to identify the smell, but in here, it really stinks. So,
it's just the smell from here. There's stains everywhere. And what scares me is the fact that the kitchen took a year to get cleaned. God knows what this took. So, pretty gross. Now, pop that in there. I'm unsure when this place was cleaned properly.
In. Oh my God.
Karen. Is Karen in here? Karen. Just come upstairs, please. 2 seconds. Please, let's go. Quick. Come in. I've just done a swab test with the carpet. I told you the smell is gross. Anything above 30, you're in the danger zone for unhygienic practices, and it's not fit for customers. What do you think the reading is?
100.
100.
50.
50.
60.
70.
70. 803.
803. Oops.
803. Oops.
Burn it.
That's not
down.
Oops. That's a
803.
Wow.
This is just the carpet. You can't be that bad.
We get a lot of bikers, bicyclists,
Karen,
and hikers.
You're paying $130 to get out of bed and step on a disgusting, stinking carpet. It smells like there's crap all over the floor.
Probably because there's crap on the floor.
Probably. Could be.
What does that mean, could be?
My first shift here, you were in the bathroom, and I think you had an accident on the floor, on the mat.
What?
Oh, my God.
I mean, yeah.
There have been times when I have had diarrhea, but it doesn't happen very often. But, no, I didn't realize that there was that problem.
Fucking hell. All day, both of you have been in denial. Not one of you told me about the problems. Not one of you have taken any form of responsibility. You were happy to serve that food to me lunchtime. You were happy to mosey around and piss around on the walls and paint silly pictures. This is a travesty. This is shocking. Your staff knows it, but you two are oblivious.
But the rest of the room is dusted and clean.
He's not talking about the room. It's not about the rug. It's not about the food. It's about the whole picture. Look at the...
Gage, you're yelling.
Am I not allowed to yell, Sarah? Because someone has to, because you're not. He's trying here to help us. Stop being in denial. It's not about the rug and this perfectly dusted thing. That this is not going to make a difference. The whole picture. The whole thing.
What are you scared of, Karen? Admitting?
Well, I'm working 16 hours a day and spending every time and money. These are rooms, too, that I get positive feedback about.
Oh, my God.
I'm serious.
A lot of positive... There you go again. No, you can't be that... No.
No, I want to fix things.
I am not sleeping in this dump. I'm done. I'm out of here. Oh, man.
You can't leave.
I'm not staying in here.
Ramsay, don't go.